In this episode of Under Attack, we get some exclusive interviews about the Yesterday's Future skateboard video and attend its video premiere in Vancouver. And later on, we get into a little trouble in Victoria and end up skating the skate barn in Seattle. So, let's start things off and learn a few things you didn't already know about Yesterday's Future.
So Yesterday's Future, that was my little baby that me and Jarvis Nigelski been working on for almost a year and a half max. But mainly over a year, we started working on this project. Jarvis came up with the name Yesterday's Future, which makes a lot of sense because these were all my favorite skaters in Canada, and I consider that they have a lot of talent, and I think they are the future of skateboarding in Canada. And I was very excited to introduce them to the world, and we took this job very seriously. Me and Jarvis were really, really ambitious about this project, and we worked really hard. We found the right sponsor, we went in the right city to skate the right spot, we had the right guy on this video. And once this video was all done and ready to be exposed to the world, we didn't go halfway. We did a big premiere in Montreal during the I'm Getting Pay, and then after that we did 9 other premiere across Canada. Like, we did a full-on tour across Canada, like from Quebec City to Newfoundland to Calgary to Toronto to Vancouver. Like, we hit all the big cities across Canada. We even did a video premiere in San Francisco, New York, Tokyo, and even Paris. Like, we went big. Like, we went big time. And I think the feedback are really, really good. We even did a collabo shoes with Vans. We did some skateboards, we did some t-shirts, like we went all off. Like, we really wanted to let the world know that those guys are the future of skateboarding in Canada. And I think some of them, you will see them in a lot of magazines, you'll hear of them, and I'm really, really happy with the result of this video. It came out real good. I know there's a lot of skate video out there in this world. It's not easy to sell a lot of them, but I think a lot of people saw it and a lot of people came to the video premiere and people were pleased. We only got very positive feedback. And basically, the Under Attack Show Season 4, that's what it's all about. It's the making of the Yesterday's Future. You'll see all the work and all the traveling and all the pain that we went through to make this video. That's exactly what Under Attack Tour Season 4 will be about. It's how hard it is to make a video. You don't make a video in a week. You gotta go through a lot of things. Skaters have to go back 2, 3, 4, 5 times sometimes to the same spot. But now you're gonna see it into the Under Attack Show, which is really cool because those guys work hard for every single trick, but you cannot put every single trick into the video because the video has to be the top-notch trick. So Under Attack Tour is gonna be quite a fun season for everyone. Plus, it's gonna be completely different. It's not a skate park tour, it's not a demo tour. It's skateboarding, it's the real life like every other skate team do. This is what Underworld did with this team. You know, we just lived the dream. We went to California, we went to Toronto, we went to Calgary, we went to Seattle. Some people went to Spain, some people went to Argentina. Like, we did it, you know, like, we didn't do it halfway. We did it like a professional way. And that's something that a lot of people are very impressed when it comes to Underworld, because we're very dedicated to skateboarding, very dedicated to our team. And that was a big project for us, and we're really happy that it's finally done, and we're very happy that we'll be able to document this this journey into the Under Attack Show. And I am really pleased to introduce you to the Under Attack Show and the making of Yesterday's Future, and I hope you enjoy it.
Yesterday's Future is a skate video that we spent about a year filming for. It features all the Underworld riders from the West Coast and the East Coast, as well as an East Coast montage of like the Friends and Flow dudes as well, and same as West Coast. It's just everyone going out and skating, family basically. My favorite part, probably Chad's. One, he's my homie, he's my brother. And two, he's amazing. Jean-Marcos, I was super hyped on. Carlos, I was hyped on the outcome. I think everyone's part of us hyped overall.
Yep, perfect.
Yeah.
I was hyped on my part, yeah, but at the same time, you know, you're your own worst critic. I wish I could have done better or I did better. But at the same time, I was happy too in the end. I've never spent that much time on a video part either. It's always been short, quick, 3-month films or 4 months or whatever, you know. That was good. The video premieres were gnarly. Montreal, I think it was the first major one that we did. We all were out there for Am Getting Paid, the Underworld's big amateur contest. Raekwon was brought out for one of the parties. It was amazing. That was probably the sickest thing. And then did the Yesterday's Future premiere as well there, which was sick too, because the crowd was hype being a lot of the riders are from Montreal and around Quebec and stuff like that, so it was good times, and Montreal's a party town. So everyone had a lot of fun out there that week. The other stops were that we did the premieres. We went to Calgary, did one. Went up to Edmonton and did one. Those were sick. We just drove out and like skated and stuff again. And, like, couldn't complain on the showings. Like, no one from the team was really from those parts, but like people still wanted to see it, so. It was good times. Edmonton, I got into a car accident with an old friend of mine. It was like, that kind of ruined me, so. But other than that, it was cool. The video premieres are like, kind of like the after party for all the work you did, even though we pretty much partied through the whole time. But the premieres were more like the actual, okay, let's go party down and enjoy what we accomplished and what we did for this whole year.
There's still more to come after this break.
Hey, this is Lee Tomaszewski, and we are standing on the red carpet at the premiere for Yesterday's Future in beautiful Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. Let's go check it out. Foley. Chris, you're obviously coming out to support some people. Who are you looking forward to seeing?
Everybody.
Everybody?
I just want to see the video.
Hey, we're standing on the red carpet with Galia Mamalu. What's up? How are you doing?
I'm all right. You know, just sort of like went skating all day and then I heard there's a video premiere, so I thought I'd come down and check it out.
Excellent. Are you here supporting anybody in particular?
Just like Underworld, you know, everyone like in the Vancouver, you know, scene. I'm like down to like, you know, rep Vancouver, you know, I'm like the skate community, you know, it's good to be a part of it and come out, you know, be seen.
Hey, it's Lee. We're standing with Steve Denham. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you.
You've actually had a chance to see the movie. How do you feel about it?
Pretty stoked, actually. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was really good production, and it's really cool to see, you know, watch guys land their tricks and go out and skate and see it all happen and then see it all be put together as well. So.
Cool. If you had a favorite trick out of the entire sequence that you did, what would you say was your favorite trick?
I think the nose wheelie around the vert bowl at Hastings and back into the 8-foot section. I think that was my personal favorite.
With Brian Cassie, a noted photographer in the skate world. How are you doing, Brian?
Pretty good today.
Excellent. So you're going inside to watch a film that you actually were a part of. How are you affiliated with it?
I didn't do any of the filming, but I was on doing photography on the trip. I went on the Calgary section and the San Francisco section. So I just did all the photos for Concrete Powder magazine. We did like full articles on both of those trips.
Awesome. Was there any particular moment in any of that you would say stood out the most in your head? What was your favorite moment?
trying to get through the border was pretty interesting.
What happened exactly?
Well, there's like 20 people in one bus. So you got skateboards and logos everywhere. And
they pull you over?
Yeah, they harass us for 5 or 6 hours. So that was pretty interesting.
That's unfortunate. And what about favorite trick?
Oh my God, that's hard.
You get to see everything. I mean, you're catching everything still alive, so you gotta have something.
Anything of Ted DeGro.
Nice.
Anything of Ted DeGro is amazing to watch.
Excellent.
Yeah, he's my favorite.
So I'm standing here with Jeff Dermer. Jeff, you've had a chance to actually see the film. What do you think?
I'm stoked. I liked it.
Excellent. And what about your part?
I'm pretty happy. You know, I film tricks that I'd never done before, and that's just what I want to keep doing. So I'm stoked. I got to pick my song, and I was stoked. And I don't know. I liked how it all fit together. Lots of my friends that I've been skating with like my whole life are in there too. So
awesome.
Yeah, I'm happy as can be.
Any memorable moments? Something that stuck out in your head?
Just every day, Jarvis picking us up at the plaza, shows up in the white van, and everyone rolls in, and that's why there's a bonus section with all the friends that just came every day out skating with us, and you get to just remember those days of summer that were just so rad.
I got here. This is Dustin Monty, and when I was watching, he got the biggest screams. What's up, Dustin?
Chilling.
So I hear your nickname is Monty, and you have somewhere on your body a tattoo with that. Where is it?
Right here on my arm.
Nice. Now, what made you decide to do that?
I don't know. Proud of the family.
Excellent. So have you seen your shots yet in this film?
I've seen it a bunch of times. We already did the premieres like 6 times across Canada so far.
Oh, so you actually got to tour with everybody. So how do you feel about it?
It's been good. It's a good experience. It's happy to see it all finished up at the end of all the filming process and all the hard work we put into it.
Well, that was yesterday's Future. I'm Lee Tomaszewski standing on the red carpet. You've been watching RIP TV. Keep it on the heel.
There's still more to come after this break. In need for a new cityscape, the boys jumped into the trusty tour bus and got on the ferry to go skate the streets of Victoria. But you'll later see things didn't go as planned.
Good crew, and we're going to Victoria. Wow. Vancouver Island. Wow. Yeah, brother.
Oh, my trip's done.
On the ocean, heading to Victoria in BC, Canada, and yeah, it's a nice day out.
Wicked vibe over there. Great skaters in Victoria.
some locals in Victoria showed us to this one ledge. It's coped. It's a manual pad too. It's pretty sick. The security comes and he gives a shit and he says he's gonna call the cops. And then the cops come. They write down Mickey here. Mickey's shit, and they phone his mom and shit. And they write down everyone else's except for the people that was in the van. And then the guys walk by, and then Alex yelled at Dustin, and the cops figured out where we were across the street, but they didn't know that we were across the street. That was the group that hanged out with Dustin.
First we get busted on the spot, now the bus is getting towed. Now we're fucking stranded in Victoria. What good is that?
So how do you like Victoria so far?
Okay, it was kind of sweet until this happened.
This is the worst day of my life. I swear to God.
So, they towed the fucking bus away, and now we're deserted in Victoria. All of us with no car, and now we have to rent a car, and we're staying here tomorrow night too. And we're gonna skate Victoria's spot. So, that's it. Hope this goes in the credits, because that'd be really cool to see Scotty's face for a minute.
Even though Victoria was a bust, the Underworld boys made a trip down south to Seattle's nearby skate barn.
Renton, Washington.
Skate barn.
Chris Connolly.
Chris Connolly, doing enough bitch makes for bullshit.
Oh. Oh my god!
Woo!
So does it.
Now what the cost of the company that's talking up your artery cholesterol, but it's better so quickly, sticky fingers grabbing the sharpen of a box cutter, bleeding the blood of a soldier older. Why is that colder arena saturated with hitters disintegrate with atom bomb drop? Now they gone, stop, as I pilot my palm on the boss, holler my name in the shadows, weaken the nemesis, better let a veteran head you off at the pass. Last samurai, deep sea diving my debonair, divine mind to shatter your glass house. Stone face, race, straight lace with mace. Beautiful irritant, omnipotent clothes, crawling around in your conscious, raising my wings, dropping tornado, covering your timetables, able to fly without leaving the ground. Cradle the cries of a generation, submitted to bit of mind of the sound. Rocky your brontosaurus, tearing up your time. Initiating your nanoseconds of renaissance. Scaling the tallest building, this become my willingness to rise. Segregated, separated from weaker species of mankind. I'm that gypsy king, one of the blue keys to part the seas. Abstract fellow, hell of a song to sing.
Crash your party like a rocket ship, back from the outer limits. Black with a lot of lip, I rock with your women in the top. I'm amazing, my other side got curious in it. Boy in the hood meets butt head with some beavers in it. So cool when I learn to leave it, learn to leave it alone. Alone, leave it alone, the blaze is chrome. With these ghetto poems, they either nothing, I leave you alone. Either up, it's like a one night stand, baby, I'm gone in the morning. Can't give you what you want, and it bounce like a comet. You can jam if I'm on it, you out of win. Gypsy gang, now I'm saying, I'm just playing the traffic or playing with matches, to see what catches. And what trust with your lane, can't remember with classics. Look, ma, no hands, now watch my magic. To the world as you know it, upside down like backflips. My approach to life is like Mike in mid-flight. Tongue out, I ain't polite. I pull off the unbelievable like clothes, that's the bare naked. Suppose you can make, now where would you take it? Stone cold with a jagged edge. I put myself across the universe, skip it like a lake. I pledge to put it down like a sledgehammer head short. God said that could be light. I'm as bright as the sun in the dark. They said we're living on borrowed time, but that don't mean much to me. I'm from a people who stole their freedom, and whatever you kill, you keep. So I keep the grip tight on the mic. It's a choking feeling, like a chokehold. The more you fight, the harder it is to breathe. And we won't let go. You can heave from home and take your dad and go on free and cheap.
Another guitar loop from the bizarre troop, dipping through your space like the infamous star group. See comments start spooking when the three stars speaking. Since we enter galactic over money? Beats,
I'm hustling.
To the three MCs, no trouble like years just to buy CDs. You see them in the store and they wear a disguise. You can tell the aliens from the look in their eyes. Even they don't realize where they come from. Fragile memories of still out of place with no space to run. And look deep into the mirror, cause you might be one. I'm trying to help you remember to the pace of the drum, so we can all fly home, cause the time has come. Ever feel out of place with no space to run? Then return to your ships, cause the time has come.
Yeah, Dustin.
work on who's got it in the wrestling. It's a fight. All right. All right, we got ourselves a winner.
Next time on Under Attack Show, we venture across the Rockies to Calgary. Along with the trip, there is Magnus Hansen, Bestamonte, Swell, Nathan Lacoste, Gianmarco Alamo, and Chad Dixon. Keep on watching, because we'll be in your town. To own this show and other videos on DVD, order online at underworldshop.com. If you'd like to know more about the music in our shows or want to know what's going on, check out our website at underattacktour.com.